Generative Fill is incredibly useful for adding objects to our scenes. But sometimes you may want more control over the strength or opacity of those objects. Ice cubes in a glass of soda, for example. I typically use a selection method like the lasso tool to highlight the area where I want the ice. Then jump into Generative Fill and type out ice cubes. What you'll notice is that the results certainly aren't terrible, but we're fully trusting Photoshop with the opacity of the output. Instead, we can now use the new selection brush, which gives us the control, not only of the opacity, but also the softness of the selection. I'll paint in where I want the ice to be, then just like before, jump into Generative Fill and type ice cubes. What we should find with these new results is that the ice cubes appear more submerged in the soda, which is thanks to the lower opacity selection. Here's one more example. I may want a slice of lemon in this drink, and using the new selection brush with a lower opacity, I'm able to get a result that looks like it's more in the center of the glass rather than right up against the walls of it. Of course, this new brush can be used for non-generative fill tasks, but we'll save that for another video. Thanks for watching, everyone. Subscribe for more content, follow me on social, and I'll see you all next time.